Do begin with the news this morning that Australians are arriving at airports this morning to the news that they will need to self-isolate as part of the government's tough coronavirus border restrictions. Thousands of people have been forced to queue at customs at Sydney Airport before entering 14 days of isolation. Prime Minister Scott Morrison spoke on the Today Show a little earlier.
The biggest risk that has presented over the last few weeks has not been by internationals because the global travel has been falling. It's actually been Australians coming home from overseas.
And we're going to go straight to some breaking news out of Melbourne this morning where Christine Ahern is standing by for us. Chris, a state of emergency has been declared. Tell us how this is going to work.
Lizzie, that's right. As of midday today, a state of emergency will come into effect in Victoria. It will last for a four-week period at least. What this means is it gives the chief health officer powers to stop the spread of the virus, anything that they need to do to protect the health of Victorians. So that includes detaining people, restricting movement, preventing entry to premises and restricting gatherings of 500 or more. For now, the Premier Daniel Andrews says that places like Federation Square and the Bourke Street Mall will remain open, as will public transport and schools. He also said that anyone that fails to comply with self-quarantine faces fines of up to $20,000 for corporate bodies. That jumps to $100,000.
These powers have never been used before. That gives you, I hope, a really clear sense about the unprecedented nature of this public health emergency.
Here at Melbourne Airport, those that missed the midnight deadline last night arriving here this morning said they understand the measures. However, they have been frustrated about the lack of information they've been receiving upon touchdown. Basically, a pamphlet is all they have been given. As for Australian flight crew arriving from overseas, they are exempt from this self-quarantine. However, when they are overseas, they must stay in their hotels. Lizzie.
Chris Ahern there with that breaking news in Melbourne. And workers at an aged care home where a resident died from coronavirus have spoken of their grief this morning. The 90-year-old woman died in hospital over the weekend after contracting the virus at her Baptist Care nursing home in Sydney.